Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to continue from my previous video that the person itself, being part of the nature, he obeys the natural laws. As in the trees, you know, you can graft the trees to produce different quality of fruit. So similarly, in human being also you can graft the same way. So they obey the same laws as obeyed by the animal, the plant kingdom. So the birth that we get, we are made of all of the same clay, whether he is a dog, bird, or a human being. We are made of the same element as of earth, but the shape we get, which is a form, which is animal, human, or could be bird, or could be a plant, or anything, that is the fruit of karma. Karma means deeds, your works. And the fruit of your works is carried forward to the next part by your mind, or man we call it, or we call it in simple way, conscience. That you see that the human being in this world, you come across, they have different conscience. Some are good, some are bad, but they are all made of the same elements of the earth. So the conscience part of the person, or of the birds, or of the anything, that belongs to God. And that does not obey any natural laws. They cannot be studied through natural law, but they are by the grace of our Father. Only Father knows the grace. So what we have to do, we have to just do our duties to glorify our Father, and we leave it to Him to give us the reward. We can't ask Him, as at the Pentecost, you know, some people said, we worked morning, can't we have more than the others? No, it's by the grace of our Father we get whatever He gives. So, the things of the Spirit, they are cannot be studied by sense. And people have tried to study this one, they failed. As Professor Keith said, the sense has just the limitation. They can't understand why some people have different conscience. And I did explain to him that the conscience, or the man we call it, it does not obey the natural laws. It is of God, and they are by the grace of our Father. And our Father knows each of us. So we get the birth into a certain family, or in a certain form, human being or animal or anything. It is all by the grace of our Father. We don't get our own, you know, birth. So after giving you this general introduction, and now we can move a little on the marriage of the son. I have written an article, and which I'm putting them in small bits. But these things are so vast, you know, that it's difficult to put everything in writing. So I have just put a little bit, And the other thing, you have to think it yourself. So Christ Jesus, it is Christ is the title, Jesus is the name. It is wrong to call Jesus Christ, as these priests call them and other people call them. So it is like Christ is a title like professor. Jesus was the name. That's why Jesus told the his laborers, don't tell everyone that he is the Christ. Because as in a university, a professor of say chemistry or physics is known to the students of physics or chemistry. Ordinary man doesn't know what professor mean and what he stands for. They know the value of that professor and they appreciate. So Christ is also a title like professor. He is the professor of spirituality, a doctor of spirituality, we can say. So Christ Jesus is the right way to address. So Christ Jesus is the anointed Son of God, eternal like our Father. So the God, although he is a combination of both male and female, as in the family of Adam, it is the male that carries the seed and represents the father. So for analogy, we also use God as our father and Holy Spirit our mother. And that's why we call his word, not her word. So there may be some other reason, which I think is, if you will also come across, you can put it through, because we learn from each other. So unless you become like little children, open your heart, you cannot understand the mysteries of God. So let's join hand together to understand these mysteries. So Christ Jesus is the anointed Son of God, eternal like our Father. He is just the opposite. Adam is born and in Adam we are born and die. In God we are eternal, just the opposite. He is also representing our Mother Holy Spirit as the anointed daughter. Christ Jesus, you know, he also represented our Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is the tongue, or the spokesperson, spokeswoman of our Father. So when Christ Jesus was preaching gospel, then he represented Holy Spirit, our mother, as an anointed daughter. Daughter with capital D, because he has the Spirit with capital S. We have the Spirit with small s, Spirit of man. And we are daughters, we are not anointed, we are just daughters of Holy Spirit with small d. So our mother, our Shakti, power, you know, Holy Spirit, could also be analogized to the tongue of our Father, delivering to us his word. So our Father does not speak, but our Mother Holy Spirit does, to feed us the living bread. So Christ Jesus, as you know, he was the embodiment of both Father and Mother. He was representing our Father when he was doing merciful deeds, protecting people. And when he was preaching gospel, he was representing our Mother Holy Spirit. So he was both a male and female. But to the ordinary man, he is known as Son, you know, Only the Christ is known to the twice born people. God bless you.